Just let me know once you are able to see my presentation.
Yeah, we can.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the event. And thanks to Isha for organizing this session. A quick introduction, like about the freelancer, and we will discuss about today about the freelancer one. Like the agenda is like a freelancer. And when coming to an introduction, there will be what is a freelancer and types of freelancing jobs and finding a freelancing job as well. And advantages and disadvantages of freelancing, and how to start this one, getting into this freelancing, and questions. And at the end of the presentation, I will take questions. Okay. Then first thing, like introduction, freelancer is a person who is self-employed and who offer the services to the company. Like it's like with to a multiple clients at the same point of time, we can work on those things. And the jobs that the freelancer performs is freelancing. It's not a tough thing, but we can do that. And usually these freelancer jobs look like it's, they will look most from your skills and experience, like what field you are into expert and how do you have any prior experience or not. And these jobs are less concerned about your locations. So it's easy to get into this one. And we have a types of freelancer jobs. It's like there are many freelancing jobs out there in the market across multiple industries and locations. So some of the industries are education, healthcare, bookkeeping, and some of the freelancer jobs are like scrum master or coach and customer services executives, etc. So, and coming to a finding job, so let's see where to find these freelancing jobs. So the quickest way to find freelancing jobs is to Google, like freelancer jobs in scrum and freelancer jobs in project management, or in as a developer. So these are the things. And another way is to search in is specific job sites, especially hosted for the freelancing jobs. Example, Upwork and Fiverr. So these are the sites we usually get a freelancing jobs where we can find it out. And these websites have multiple jobs across the globe and hundreds of freelancer looking for the jobs too. So apart from these websites, we can also find freelancer jobs in seek.com and social media, or with families and friends like colleagues discussing about our experience and skills and building up the network and attending some events. So there is a lot like we are having now at present. So attending events and everything. So, and here, you may find any opportunities, and most of the times is like fantastic ideas or opportunities occurs in the formal meetings. Okay. And it always better have to look to the same opportunities where you were looking for. And when in these freelancing jobs, we have and both advantages and disadvantages. So like any other item, freelancing has its own advantages and disadvantages. So let's discuss about some of these things. So some of the advantages, we can work from anywhere and we can work based upon our flexibility. It's like, say example, if we are working for an Indian client, we can work based upon our flexibility rather than like with an Indian timing. So if you are feasible with the Indian timing as well, you can work on those timing as well. Say example, like I have worked for one of the Indian company. It's a startup company. Like I working as a scrum master. So usually I will work for per day 2 hours. So based upon my feasibility. So usually I'm working woman. I'm working for NAB actually at present. So my timing, my job will finish at 5:30. So I usually works at later at 7 o'clock or 9 o'clock based upon my feasibility after my work, everything is being done. So we have that much of flexibility in this freelance job. And we can find variety of projects as well based upon our experience and the skills. And coming to the pay, they will have a good pay in this one. And some of the disadvantages are finding clients. We need to find the right client based upon our skills and experience rather than random projects. And another challenge is accountability. So we have to make sure that we are the complete owing ownership of this work. So starting from the taking up the project till the say example the presentations and having a client meetings and etc. We should make a complete accountability of those the work the project and even the workloads as well. So we have to manage our work life balance. So we have everything here. So these are the some of the disadvantages we usually find in this one. And one second was okay. Yeah, and getting started for this one, initially there will be a challenges to get started with any new journey. So and we will going to adapt to it later on, but we will look how to get into this one. Okay, how to get started. So we need to set a goal. Okay, I'm into this field, so I want to go into the same projects, like same work, or and to get that job, what type of skills I need it. Okay, and in that, what skills and in what ways I can improve my skills to get into that work. Okay, and we need to build our portfolio and we have to showcase ourselves, like we have to present ourselves to the job or interviewer, like we have to sell ourselves in a proper way so that our dreams come true and our passion comes true and everything we can make it out. And finding your clients and connecting with the people. Okay, we should always be connecting with the people and the clients. So it makes to keep actually looking for the opportunities. Okay, participating in the networking events. So once we get connected to the client, keep an impressive pitch about yourself and your work. That is most important. And staying connected is another task to have a good client connected. So these are the some of the initial steps to take to get started with the freelancing jobs. So yeah, I hope you all have got some understanding from this session. So now we will going to take up some questions. So these are quick introduction. I just want to give a basic information about the what is freelancing, those things. Yeah.
So Praveena, I think this is something which can help people who are trying to get experience even in Australia, like they are on break and they want to come back to IT. So do you think these freelance projects could help them?
Yes, of course. Yeah. So because it doesn't look for the location, so they can try to get these jobs initially and they can add it as in their experience and they can try with their Australian jobs as well.
Yeah, I think you're right, because even if we are not, it may not count as an Australian experience as such, as a local experience, but when the recruiter asks us, so what have you been doing lately? It's always good to say that, I'm in touch with technology because I have done so and so freelance projects, right?
Yeah. In these projects, we can make people can recommend us to the freelancing jobs. Like, say, example, I have already done one of the project through as a freelancer. Then anybody can recommend me as well. Like, yeah, she's a good candidate. Then we'll get a weightage to our resume and as well as to our skills and the work. So which gives a lot of experience as well to apply to the other jobs outside of the freelancer one.
Does anybody else have a question? No, I have just one more then, because I tried a bit of freelancing. I like to try different things. What I felt is, initially, how do you build your profile? Because I have never done freelancing things. And when I look at the other people, they have done so many projects. They have some stars, some points. So how do you, you know, like break into it and get the clients?
Okay. So the thing is, first thing is our resume should be an impressive way. And the second thing, like we need to search for the projects and try to apply them and connect to them. Okay. Call them. If you have any contact number or anything, you can contact them and try to reach out them. Okay. And you can present, you have to present yourself like in a such a way that you are based upon your experience and the skills. Okay. So that is the most important thing. Yeah. And later on, like once you are ready to that one, even the employer is ready for that one, and we can make sure like, yes, we are ready to do this. And if they may ask for any references, yes, we are ready to provide like based upon our previous experience.
Okay.
Yeah.
I had a question. Actually, I few months back, I created an account with Upwork. And I was starting to, like, I searched for a few projects and all, as per my experience and what I could provide. But the major challenge I faced was every time I used to approach a potential client, I had to put up my work, as in, like, some example or something. But for that, I did not understand what to put up. Because I never worked as a freelancer. So in that case, how should we deal with it? You know, like sometimes you have to show that this were my previous work. This is how I have created and whatever the project is. So if someone is completely new, just like me, so how should I make my profile on such websites so that at least client have shows some trust to someone new?
Okay. Try to get references. Okay. So that they can recommend you on these things. Like, say example, in a LinkedIn, usually we will going to upload our profiles, but later most of the people will connect through our recommendations as well. It makes very easier.
But that is only possible when you know someone who is doing freelancing, right?
Yeah, and make up your work skills show. Like, say, example, see, if I'm a painter, so I can say with an example, if I'm a painter, how do I, that person knows, like, I'm a good painter. So I can draw it and I can post it in a social media so that it will make sure, like, yes, she is a good painter. And that's how you will going to show up your skills. Okay. Do some project. Okay. Like a startup projects or any project which you are working on. Okay. And show up that skills. Okay.
Think last time when I created, maybe it's a latest thing, but they have added that they can connect with your LinkedIn. And I mean, like it's a full office profile. So I did actually started getting freelancing work after 1 or 2 weeks. I don't know whether they would have worked out or not, because I decided not to go there later on. But I did. I think what I did is I put my resume in the portfolio, in the project we do have to put. So I put the one which I think you know, like, I can share, because we cannot always share our projects. We have to generalize. Yeah, we can't give the details, but a generalize in description only.
Yeah, and start with your network first and try to present your own projects. So at least one project like which you have done. Show up that one. Any project. Okay. So
okay.
At least basic information, try to show up with them so that they will make sure that, yes, you are like eligible for that, for the work, and like create your own projects or at least Yeah, you can do that one, right? Creating projects. Yes, we can make that one and show up. There is a lot of platforms are there like to showcase our projects.
Yeah.
You can do that one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, no worries.
I think maybe when Trisha or anybody is doing, they can, you know, if they face a roadblock, they might ping you that time and just check if you have available, you can check what is missing, and that would be a better way to get them started. Because I think this is something which freelancing is something which really helps in the early career.
Early career as well as for the homemaker as well. So if they doesn't get like time to with the family, so they can make it out as well. And who are working, if they want to do as their passion, so they can make it out. Contribute in expert firms as well. So it will make increase your network. That's the most important thing. So contribute in the firms like and the events like Hackathon.
Yeah.
So I can take up some questions as well, maybe offline. So I'm available.
Yeah, I think that's good, Praveena. It's a very informative. I think freelancing is something we all know the size, but we want to try. I really liked your sheet where you put what are different types of freelancing we can do.
Yeah.
And then, of course, I think this is the first is the roadblock is, you know, how to get the first project. And maybe it's not as difficult because I think we have not tried. We just look at others' profile and we just stop there because we haven't done like Trisha was saying. So it might help.
We can sit at home and we can do that. Rather than nowadays, we are going directly and having a face-to-face interviews. So we can do this one as well. We are facing lots of challenges day by day with the interviewers and with the work. But why can't we try this one as well? Don't stop doing all these things. We can make it out for sure.
Okay. Thank you, Praveena. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for everyone for joining the session.
And thank you.
Interaction with you all.